Okay, Stan, you've been doing good, doing really good. Last night, you went to bed without any of the ice cream sundaes. Yep, check that off the list. This morning when you woke up, you didn't have any of the sugary cereal. Nope, you had the brand. In fact, you're still having the brand. Ugh, it's so chewy. Ugh. Oh, hi, boys and girls. It's me, Stan the Stuntman. Yeah, and all month long we've been talking about honesty, and I should probably be honest with you, I haven't exactly been taking the best care of myself. Well, I had a doctor's appointment recently, and the doctor told me that he wanted to know all the sugars I've been eating. And I told him the usual, you know, the Pop-Tarts, the ice cream, the cake, all that good stuff, the donuts. Mm. And the doctor stopped me and said, "No, Stan, not everything you've eaten in your lifetime, just on a daily basis." And I told him, "Doc, that was my daily basis." And he said I probably needed to eat healthier, which is true. You probably should take good care of yourself, but it's just... I've been doing really good. I've been trying to eat more salads and trying to eat less donuts, but it's just been so long since I've had sugar. And sugar's just really good, you know? It just gets the blood pumping. And I just... Hey, what's that over there? Guys! Crumbly Fluff just turned on their Hot Now sign. They're like one of the bestest donut places ever. Their donuts are the crispiest, the creamiest, and it's just... awesome! Oh, but now they've got one of those you can get one for free if you go in there. And I'm just I know I probably shouldn't, but I just really want one. It's Crumbly Fluff! I gotta go get my car keys! Crumbly Fluff, wait for me!
Okay, all right, got this started. I'm buckled in. I'm ready to go to Crumbly Fluff. Okay, here we go. I can see the light.
Hey!
What are you doing?
Stan! I thought you were a professional driver!
I am! And how do you know my name?
Well, I'm a truth sleuth. It's my job to know the truth.
Oh, okay then.
And where are you going?
But where am I going?
Yeah.
nowhere? Nowhere in particular?
Mm-hmm. It wouldn't be to get one of these delicious...
donut? No, I'm not going to get a donut. That would be silly. Who goes to get sweet, delicious donuts with sprinkles on them?
You know what? I think I'm just going to set this right here. And I'm going to take a little nap. I'm just a little tired from watching too much TV last night.
Oh, well, that's bad for your health.
Yeah, just a little nap.
Okay. Oh, donut. Oh, it's so good. No, I can't eat the donut. No, I have to wait till I get the Crumbly Fluff. I can't just be eating every donut I see. That would be irresponsible. And I, Stan the Stuntman, am not irresponsible. I am responsible. That's right. Just keep up. Oh, keep going. Hand, what are you doing? Why are you betraying me? No, don't do it. We are stronger than this. We just oh, who am I kidding? It's a donut!
Stan! Stan! Where are you going? Stan, calm down. Just calm down.
That was delicious. No, I know. I can't calm down. I need to get to Crumbly Fluff and get more donuts.
Well, I think you really need to listen to today's Bible story. It's about food and how someone chose to do the right thing, even when it was hard.
Crumbly Fluff! I need more Crumbly Fluff!
Okay, how about this? I'll help you get to Crumbly Fluff if you promise to listen to today's Bible story.
You will?
Yes.
Okay, I can do that.
Okay, good. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, turn left here.
Left here? Oh, okay.
Good job.
Okay.
And turn left here.
Another left?
Uh-huh.
Well, I mean, I guess the road just kind of naturally curves like this, but okay. Man, I'm so excited. I feel like besides that donut I just scarfed down, I haven't had a donut in like forever. It was delicious.
Turn left here.
Well, it's the same left. What do you mean, another
left
turn?
Put your listening ears on. Today's Bible story is coming up next.
Hey, do I turn right here?
No, go ahead. Turn left.
Left? Okay.
We're almost there.
Hi friends, my name is Miss Paris and I get to tell you a pretty amazing story from this book. Can you kids tell me what this book is called? That's right, the Bible. And if it's in the Bible, then we know it's
true.
Good job. Well, today's true story begins with the king of Babylon, who had a very long name. His name was King Nebuchadnezzar. Can you kids say that with me? King Nebuchadnezzar. Good job. That's kind of hard. Well, today I have some boxes that I'm going to use to help me tell our story. Show me a thumbs up if you think we should open box number one and see what's inside.
Yeah!
Okay, let's see. Oh, it's a heavy weight. No wonder this box was heavy when I picked it up earlier. King Nebuchadnezzar was looking for some of God's people to be in his training program. He wanted the very best, the strongest, and healthiest men for his program. Now, show me a thumbs up if you're ready to see what's inside our box number two. Can you show me? Good job. Okay, let's see. Oh, it's an A+. Whoever wrote this paper must be really smart. The king was also looking for men who were very smart. One of those men was named Daniel. Daniel loved God and followed him. Daniel did what God told him to do. Are you ready to open box number three?
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. Let's see what's inside. Oh, we have food. Look at all of this yummy food. Nebuchadnezzar wanted Daniel and all of the other men in his training program to eat the food that came from the king's table. Foods like steak, chicken, pizza, cookies, and cake. Raise your hand if you like cake. I do too. But there was a problem for Daniel. Remember, Daniel loved God and followed him. And back then, God had rules about what his people could eat. That meant that Daniel would have to say no to all of the fancy food on the king's table. That would be kind of hard, right? Daniel would have to say no to the king, and people normally did not say no to the king. Now, show me a thumbs up if you're ready to open up box number four. Okay, let's do it. We have grapes and water, there's pears and apples, all healthy food, right? Daniel knew that it would be wrong for him to eat from the king's table. So Daniel asked for permission to not eat the king's food. The king's helper in charge of the men in training didn't like this idea. He was afraid that Daniel would look weaker than the other men, and he would get in trouble with King Nebuchadnezzar. But Daniel asked if he could eat the food that God wanted him to eat. He told the king's helper that he would only eat vegetables and drink water for 10 days. Can you kids show me your 10 fingers? Good job. After that time, the king's helper could compare Daniel to the other men who were eating from the king's table. And if Daniel was weaker, then the king's helper could decide what to do next. The king's helper agreed to let Daniel eat vegetables and drink water for 10 days. And guess what? Daniel looked healthier than the men that had been eating from the king's table. Daniel ate the way God wanted him to eat. Even though Daniel was young, he knew he wanted to do what God wanted him to do. It can be hard to live in a truthful way, but Daniel knew God would help him choose to do the right thing. Daniel could have chosen to eat from the king's table. All of the food looked really yummy, but Daniel chose to do what God would have wanted him to do by eating the vegetables and drinking water. When we need help being honest, we can always ask God for help. Who can help me be honest? God can help me be honest. Yes, he can. We can do what is right wherever we are. Are you kids ready to pray together? Okay, clap your hands and bow your heads. Dear God, thank you for our true story in the Bible about Daniel. Help us to always be honest and truthful, even whenever it is hard. We love you so much, and all God's children said,
Amen. Amen.
Thanks for listening, friends. We'll see you next time. Bye.
Oh, hi, everyone. I'm Stan the Stuntman, and I have our memory verse for the whole month of October. Are you guys ready? Anyone who lives without blame walks safely. But anyone who takes the crooked path will get caught. Proverbs 10:9.